Hello students. Student, today we are going to learn addition and subtraction of matrices. How can matrices are added and subtracted? Student, remember, same order matrices are added or subtracted. Okay. If both orders are equal, then the matrices are added or subtracted. Question number 1, you can say, student, if A equals to 1, minus 2, 3 and 0, 1, 2, B equals to minus 3, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4. We have to find out A plus B and A minus B. Students, you can see, students, order of A is 2 by 3. Order of B also 2 by 3. Both orders are same. Then A and B can be added. Okay, students. So A plus B equals to A matrix plus B matrix. Now, students, corresponding elements are added. Okay, 1 plus minus 3. So 1 minus 3, minus 2 plus 0. 3 plus 1, 0 plus 1, 1 plus 2, and 2 plus 4. So 1 minus 3 minus 2, minus 2, 3 over 1, 4, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 2, 3, 2 or 4, 6. So student, A plus B equals to minus 2, minus 2, 4, 1, 3, 6. Now student, we have to subtract B from A. For subtraction, students, put the values of A and B matrices, and same way we have to subtract. Now corresponding elements are subtracted. 1 minus minus 3, minus 2 minus 0, 3 minus 1, 0 minus 1, 1 minus 2, and 2 minus 4. So it will become 1 plus 3, 1 plus 3, 4, minus 2 minus 0 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2, 0 minus 1 minus 1, 1 minus 2 minus 1, and 2 minus 4 minus 2. So students, you have to remember that same order matrices are added and subtracted. Okay, if two matrices are there which have different order, then matrices cannot be added or subtracted. Now students, we are going to learn properties of addition of matrices. Okay students, addition of matrices is commutative. Means, if we add A plus B or B plus A, both are equal. Okay students, addition of matrices is associative. If you see, there are three matrices A, B, C of same order. Okay. Then we can add first A plus A and B, then C, or we can add first B and C, then A, then the result will be same. Now third property, students, existence of additive identity. Zero or null matrix represented by O, zero or null matrix is the identity matrix for a matrix A of same order. If A equals to this matrix Aij m into n, then O is a null matrix of same order. The result should be A plus O equals to A equals to O plus A. Okay. Because zero matrix or null matrix give us the same result when we add it in any matrix. That's why zero is called additive identity. Now, existence of additive inverse. Students, if there are two matrices A and B, are two matrices of same order, then B is called inverse of A if A plus B equal to 0. Okay, students, if sum of two matrices equals to zero matrix or null matrix, then second matrix is known as additive inverse of first matrix, V equal to minus. So students, these are the properties of addition of matrices. Now we are going to learn how can we multiply a matrix by a scalar. Multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. If student A equal to this, scalar means any number or any constant value. 3 is a scalar here. Now we have to multiply the matrix by 3. It means 3 multiplied by A. So 3 multiplying, we have to write the matrix as it is. Then each element will be multiplied by 3. Okay? So 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6, 3 4 is 12, 3 0 is 0, 3 8 is 24, and 3 minus 1 equals to minus 3. Okay, students? So in general, we can write if A is a matrix of order m into n, and lambda is a scalar. So lambda A equals to A lambda or lambda AI m into n. Okay, so this is the method of multiplying any scalar, you know, to a matrix. Okay, you have to remember when a scalar is multiplied with a matrix, then it is multiplied to each element of the matrix. Okay, students? Okay, then.